What if the sun disappeared for 5 seconds? Seems like a really odd question, but I mean, this is Life's Biggest Questions, and if you've been a subscriber to this channel for very long, you probably know that we're not afraid of an odd question or two. 5 seconds isn't very long, but the sun is also so vital to everything on Earth, as well as to the rest of our solar system. Even if it only disappeared for 5 seconds, that 5 seconds would be enough to cause some serious damage. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that imagines the impossible. I'm your host, Charlotte Dobre, and thanks for checking out another video. If this is your first time here, subscribe for more daily videos that will make you scratch your head. And if you're on social media, check out the description for our social media handles. The sun is 330,000 times the mass of our Earth, and every single second it produces as much energy as 100 billion hydrogen bombs. The sun is so big that it's the dominant gravitational force in our solar system, and 8 planets along with countless space objects orbit around it. To sum it all up, we need the sun. If it went anywhere, even for just 5 seconds, shit would definitely go down. It takes 8 minutes for light from the sun to reach the Earth, so if the sun disappeared for 5 seconds, we wouldn't even know about it until 8 minutes later. If the sun disappeared for 5 seconds, the parts of the world that were experiencing daylight at the time would get a very quick 5-second night, where the stars are visible. The parts of the world that were experiencing night at the time that the sun disappeared wouldn't see the moon because the moon's light is reflected from the sun. It would be complete and total darkness, minus the light from electricity. If the sun disappeared for 5 seconds, it wouldn't be too big a deal at first. We would still have electricity for those 5 seconds. Plants would stop making food because without the sun there's no photosynthesis. They of course would continue making food after the sun returned after 5 seconds. It can be assumed that the planet will get quite a bit cooler for those 5 seconds, and the average temperature could even drop to 0 degrees Celsius. This would probably be quite a shock for people who lived in warmer climates. Imagine going about your day when all of a sudden the sun went out, and the air was quite a bit cooler. It's not necessarily the light from the sun going out for 5 seconds that I'm worried about. It's how it would affect gravity in our solar system. The sun provides heat and light for our solar system, but the sun also holds everything in our solar system in place. Interestingly, before Einstein, scientists assumed that gravity acted instantaneously, but in his theory of general relativity, Einstein pointed out that the force from gravity isn't instantaneous. Gravity travels at the speed of light as well, so we would see the sun go out and we would feel it disappear at the exact same time. If the sun disappeared, even if it were just for 5 seconds, all the objects in our solar system would assume an unstable orbit. They would then be sent flying in the direction that they were headed, in a straight line rather than continuing on their elliptical orbits. The Earth orbits the sun at a speed of 67,000 miles per hour, or 30 miles per second. Do a bit of math and the Earth's orbit would change by less than a kilometer. Even though this doesn't seem like much, this could cause our planet to move further away from the sun, so when it goes back into orbit, the Earth could be quite a bit cooler. This would affect the environment in many ways. Certain plants can't survive in cooler weather, and certain species of animals who rely on the heat would also suffer. It's difficult to determine just how much a change in temperature would affect life on Earth, but as we have seen, a drop in temperature has caused many different species to go extinct. Even though the sun and its gravity would return after 5 seconds, in extreme cases, its temporary disappearance would cause the objects in our solar system to be knocked off course, where eventually they could float away into space entirely and be lost forever, or they would eventually crash into other objects in our solar system. Again, any crashes wouldn't happen right away because gravity also travels at the speed of light, but throwing our planets off course would definitely have long-term implications. Apart from the sun's obvious jobs, you might not have known this, but the sun also creates a magnetic field around the solar system. This field is called the heliosheath, and it deflects harmful radiation particles that come from outside our solar system. Take away the sun and our heliosheath is gone, which means that all the radiation that is currently blocked will be able to make it into our solar system. Once the sun returned, the heliosheath would be far less able to safely deflect all the radiation that bombards our solar system from space. On the bright side, we would see beautiful aurora light up the atmosphere, but on the negative, electrical grids we rely on would short out, and satellites that are currently in orbit might stop functioning. This already happens when solar flares hit our planet. Thankfully, the sun isn't going anywhere anytime soon, and it definitely isn't disappearing for 5 seconds anytime soon either. But hopefully this video has given you some insight on how important our sun actually is. For now, it's that part of the video where I'm going to respond to some of your comments. These are from our last video, How Dangerous is the Dark Web? Carlito Chicken said, "What if school was never created?" Well, I think we would probably be quite a bit dumber, to be quite frank. K. Juan Gold said, almost to 1 million. So glad to be one of the first subscribers since 50,000. Thanks so much for sticking around with us through our World War III days. We appreciate you. We are also planning on doing a live stream at 1 million subscribers, so you finally get to see who your narrators are. Toxin said, do a video on if the multiverse is real. We've actually done a couple videos on this topic, like is the universe infinite and are we living in a simulation? But I like your idea. It's more specific. I'll run it by the big guy. Biohazard said, you guys deserve a lot more respect. Asking questions no one asks for, but the concept is so puzzling. Thank you, LBQ. You are very welcome. I'm glad you enjoy our videos. Alfredo Diaz said, what if Life's Biggest Questions had its own TV show? I'd probably watch it. Actually, that's a lie. I probably wouldn't. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you like this video, you will love the playlist that's clickable on your screen. And make sure you subscribe so we can see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.